Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this latest version of Tales from Outer Space, where I take an HFY story from somewhere around the internet and read it aloud for your enjoyment. All the relevant links are down below. Like, subscribe, and all that YouTube gumph to help this video and channel grow. Anyways, as always, I hope that you enjoy. I would just like to thank the following Tier 5 patrons and channel members for supporting the channel. Datamagnet and Bob the Dragon. Thank you again, and now on to the story. The correct answer, written by Ogosh. Chilik vibrated in place, his talons clicking softly against the smooth, gray floor of the Department of First Contact Affairs. Despite his normally composed, professional demeanor, he was experiencing a first in his entire career as the First Contact Liaison. And, in his mind, he would be forgiven for the childlike enthusiasm with which he bounced. To his side were two other liaisons that had arrived for the appointment that followed his, both giving sideways glances to the bubbly yet clay bureaucrat. Tilik felt half bad for them. His meeting would take the rest of the day. The door beside Tilik slid silently to one side as the Yavri attendant stepped through, accompanied by another Yitle First Contact liaison. The liaison had a look of a business-as-usual boredom on his face as he walked away, lifting his hollow pad to check his schedule. The Yavri attendant, a quadrupedal three-eyed alien covered in blue-gray fur, wished that the other liaison farewell before turning to face Tilik. "Mr. Tilik, haven't it?" she asked, her voice barely a whisper. One of her hands twitched at a gesture at her side. "Ah, yes," Tilik spoke double her volume, bowing slightly to the attendant. "We're ready for you." She motioned for him to enter the room on one hand and twitched another gesture with the other. Tilik walked into the near-silent room as his talons continued to click across the floor, echoing off the empty walls on the conference hall. Seated at the table at the far end of the room was Talik's three superiors. His supervisor, a bipedal alien covered in stone-like protrusions, his supervisor, another Yavri, and what Talik could only assume was the department's director. Basankai woman, 10 feet tall with a dozen spindly legs and four equally lanky arms. Talik guessed that when word got out about the results of his mission, the top brass wanted to confirm it firsthand. This was his first time meeting his boss's boss's boss, let alone a Basankai. He suddenly felt doubly nervous.
"Welcome back, Tilik," began Hawk, his supervisor. "You've met Tenfa, acting head of our department."
The Aubrey nodded wordlessly. A gesture Tilik returned.
"To his right is the head of First Contact Affairs, Miss Five Moons of Longing. After your initial report, she wished to oversee these proceedings personally."
The Basankai leaned over her table, eyes fixed on the little bureaucrat. Yitle was by no means the largest race in the galactic community, but Leek still felt overpowered. "Mr. Aventilt," boomed Five Moons in a deep tenor voice, "I do not need to remind you that my time is precious, and you will be severely punished for wasting it if you falsified your report. So, I will ask only once. Did your aliens answer the question correctly?" Tilik hesitated. He knew he'd done nothing wrong, and the report was truth. Every word. He just needed to find his calm. He closed his eyes and took a deep breath. When he opened them again, he found confidence in his three words.
"Yes, they did."
Five Moons returned back to her table.
"Then, let us begin. Hawk."
Hawk tapped several keys on his data pad, and the wall behind Tilik at the front door of the room lit up with a series of screens, each containing a unique set of data related to his report, as well as the first contact protocols and jargon. Hawk cleared his throat.
"Please state your name, ID number, and the planet of your observation for the record of this proceeding."
"Tilik Aventilt, First Contact Liaison number 45-45-8912, observing Arm 9, reporting of first contact for the race of aliens known as humans of planet Earth." As Tilik spoke, his words were translated to text that scrolled down on the screen behind him.
human and Earth were both being flagged for clarity later. You may begin, Mr. Avendelt.
Thank you. Talik stepped forward, wearing his datapad, readying several specific parts of his report he knew would be referenced. In accordance with the First Contact Protocol, First Contact was conducted following a three-cycle observational period of the alien's planet in order to acquire information regarding their culture, scientific advancement, language, and mannerisms. It was found that during this period, the humans, hereafter referred to as humanity, had several cultures and only rudimentary universal mannerisms.
Could you give us an example of the universal mannerism? Quietly interjected the Yavri supervisor, Dinfar.
Certainly.
Talik tapped on his datapad and a new screen blinked in behind him, displaying a human male with tan skin bearing his fangs. As you can see, this specimen is displaying his teeth while tensing several muscle groups in his face that makes the sides of his mouth curl upwards. This is seen by humanity as a sign of joy and was emulated during first contact to establish trust.
Talik swiped the picture off his screen and continued.
After humanity had passed each of our standards for initiating contact, humanity's ruling class was contacted at the beginning of Cycle 3. As expected, this caused panic in several settlements around the planet, though violence was contained to smaller incidents. After one cycle period, a single representative of humanity was selected for interview aboard the liaison vessel. This proved to be the most difficult step of the process.
And why is that? Asked Hawk.
Almost before he finished speaking, Talik had displayed several data points about planetary conditions, including gravity, atmospheric composition, temperature, and weather variations. Save for the hum of the computers, the room fell into an uncomfortable silence.
This cannot be correct, mumbled Five Moons.
I assure you it is.
Are those temperature ranges accurate?
Yes, though very few humans actually live in the extremes.
And the weather, they really experience such devastation.
Dozens of times per cycle. Satisfied with the stunned silence that followed, Talik continued. The proceedings continued for several hours, Talik giving a thorough walkthrough of the entire process. Though this was mostly for the report. Everyone in the room was now waiting on one specific part, the question.
Once the interview chamber had been conditioned to Earth's habitat and humanity had selected its ambassador, he was teleported aboard the liaison ship and I personally conducted the interview. My full report will contain the entirety of the interview, but for the purpose of this hearing, I've highlighted the final questioning of the ambassador.
The three supervisors leaned in over the table at the monitors.
Finally, the part that they had been waiting for. Talik tapped on his datapad, and a single screen filled the entirety of the wall. The video showed a human adult male, slightly taller than Talik, sitting opposite of him at a white table with several small displays and a translator blinking. Text superimposed over the human read, Eric Larsen of Norway. He was dressed in what appeared to be a black full body covering in crisp, ordered style, accented with a white under covering.
You are being very patient with us, Eric. Thank you, said Talik in the video. They could see that Talik made an effort to curl the sides of his mouth upward to emulate a smile.
I only have one question left before we conclude. Once we are finished, you'll be returned to the same place that you were retrieved, and a copy of this interview will be given to your government for its records.
Of course,
Eric replied with a wave as he folded his hand. His voice was calm and even.
Mr. Larson, according to your previous answers, you marked the present recorded year of your civilization as 2005 cycles of a common era, correct?
That's correct.
And in the time since your species began recording its history, you've gone from shaping stone tools to harnessing the power of nuclear fission, exploring extraplanetary bodies, including a manned mission to your own moon, and the creation of a global digital communication network. The ability for your species to learn and grow has accelerated at, frankly, a startling speed, and shows no sign of stopping. Eric didn't speak, though his head nodded up and down slowly.
However,
In this time, you've also informed us of incidents of incredible violence carried out by your species, including two within the last 100 cycles. Incidents you refer to as world wars. Even recently, one of your nations, the United States, became a victim of a loss of life event that resulted in the nation mobilizing for war with several others. Eric continued to nod, though without a smile. My final question is this. Do you believe humanity is ready to be lifted into the galactic community? The supervisors watched with bated breath. Here it comes. No, replied Eric. The supervisors exhaled in relief. Hawk chuckled. No, repeated Talik. Could you explain why? Humanity has made incredible strides towards peace in recent history. By our standards, we live in the most peaceful and prosperous time of our history. But it is not enough. We have many problems, Mr. Oventilt. Problems that humanity would only carry over into your community if we joined now. It would be unfair to both of us to burden you with them. If humanity is to make it to the stars, it should be as one, undivided, and that is a lesson that we have not yet learned. The video paused and silence fell over the room once again. Talik looked over his superiors, brimming with the pride of a parent. Hawk spoke first. They answered right, he chuckled. We so rarely find sentient species that make it past the three-cycle filter. The ones that remain are too eager to leave their world and express no humanity, stated Five Moons. This species, despite its violence, recognizes its own faulty behavior. It is a good first step. The Basenkai typed for a few moments on a datapad, collecting all the data from the report and ending the recording. And we can guide them from here.
Good work, Talik.
Hawk nodded at his subordinate.
We'll move forward with lifting procedures following the submission of this report to the governance of allied races. That'll be all.
Talik gave a deep bow before shuffling out the door with the Yavari attendant. Walking down the hall back to his office, Talik couldn't help but curl the sides of his mouth again. Welcome, humanity. End of story.
And that, my friends, concludes this video. I hope that you enjoyed, and if you do, please consider supporting the author, even by popping over and leaving a thumbs up or a nice comment, just to show your appreciation for the story. However, if you wish to support this channel, there are links down below which will help immensely. I will see you all in the next one, and until then, I hope that you have a fantastic day. Cheers.